Oh. I mean, I gotta start out videos with synthesizers, I think. All right, I'm about to do a series of videos on this thing called Vertical. It's an R package that we've made for using R as a full stack, basically to create content, curate it, and communicate it in a reproducible format. So we're thinking this could be useful for psychologists. And what I want to do in this video is motivate Vertical a little bit and show you around it. I'm planning to do a whole bunch more videos on little pieces about this thing. So first we'll talk about some reasons to adopt a reproducible workflow and explain a little bit about how that would work in R. Here's a couple of links in case you're following along. Here's the link to the Vertical package. We could check it out right here. It's basically an install through GitHub. We'll check this page out. If you want to read more about what we're thinking, go here and check out the preprint. This should be in press at Behavioral Research Methods pretty soon. I'm working on a tutorial example of how to put a Vertical project together. It's right here. Just to give you a heads up, we're talking about ways in which you can make your paper in R, make supplemental materials using R, say R Markdown, write your slides, write your posters, even functions and data, package all that together, and then be able to serve a web page that looks something like this using PackageDown. So for example, the slideshow we're looking at right here is actually contained on this web page under Vertical Overview. But we'll get to that later. Okay. So for me, in this slide, what I've done is I put science in a nutshell. I know, bad joke. And I've got some squirrels here. And the squirrels represent some things we do in science. So on the one hand, we do things. We crack these, squirrels crack nuts, I guess. And then once we do our things, we want to communicate them, right? And a question that we can ask is, how do we know that what you did is equal to what you said you did? And this is a question about validating assumptions and assertions that other researchers have made. This kind of verification is potentially possible with reproducible research workflows, where you could, say you've done some stuff in your paper. You said you got certain data, you said you did a certain analysis and you got these numbers. And if someone else wanted to double check, they could download your stuff. And if it's reproducible, they should be able to run a check that shows if they perform the same steps that you said you did, that they get the same answers. And we can basically facilitate this using R Markdown pretty easily. There's some organizational reasons. So for me, I wish I could have saved my future self from my past self on many occasions because my file system and organization strategy is totally a mess. We don't necessarily get trained on how to create our own workflows. And some of them are organized. And I've got some that are organized. They're not always organized. Some are not. I've been in a position where I don't know what I did in the past and I have to redo everything over again. It's annoying. And so I've certainly benefited from a reproducible workflow. Like, it's really fun to go back to a project a year ago where I started using these workflows and I can demonstrate for myself that all the things that I did are working and I don't have to kind of reinvent the wheel. I think that my hands are a problem child when it comes to touching data, and I basically don't want my hands to touch anything because I know I'm going to screw something up. So if we can get a script in between the data and doing something to that data, then we can be confident in how the data is being handled. And so I think, yeah, of course, human error is normal, common, and inescapable. And if we use our hands to do things, we are going to make mistakes. And if we use a reproducible workflow, we can identify the errors and potentially correct them. Also, in this context, if you use vertical, then you could be introducing yourself to a way to learn new useful and generalizable skills. So vertical really is just a kind of wrapper for a bunch of things you can do in R. And to make full use of the approach, you could be using this as an opportunity to develop R skills. Just as a side note, I'm new to recording these kinds of videos. My computer fan is heating up. I don't know if you can hear that. I'm annoyed. I don't want this to happen, but I'm going to keep going even if this fan noise is loud. Okay, so I made this overview picture of what vertical is. I look at this and it's like, oh, I don't know if this is super helpful, but the vertical makes use of a whole bunch of really great R packages. And the only reason I called it vertical is because it kind of represents a full stack of things that we can use. It's barely a package in and of itself. It just helps you pull together a workflow. We'll talk about what it actually does later. Briefly, it gives you an RStudio project template. But here's what we're talking about here. There's three steps: creating, curating, and communicating. And so when it comes to like creating assets in terms of a psych research project, your assets could be an APA paper. It could be a poster. It could be slide decks. It could be psychology experiments, such as behavioral experiments that you could run on the web. In fact, there are ways to create all of these different kinds of content using R Markdown. So in step one, we can be using RStudio to make a lot of the content we're making, and we can do it in a reproducible way using R Markdown. We'll talk more about R Markdown later, but what's really cool about it is you can mix and match regular verbiage, like you can write stuff down, and you can embed code in it as well. And so this lets you do a whole bunch of things, including having one kind of document. So you're basically writing this R Markdown document, and we can export it into a whole bunch of different kinds of formats: PDFs, web pages, slide decks, Word documents, and so on. And so it's a really powerful content creation workflow. So let's say we had a project where we created all these kinds of content. What we're going to suggest in vertical is that you curate that content using the R package standard. So that is to say, if you're going to have a paper and you're going to have slide decks and all this stuff and data and possibly some functions, and you know, how should you store it in a folder? How should it be organized? And we're talking about inheriting a standard. There's already an organization system in R for writing an R library or package. And it turns out, I think it's pretty convenient structure that we could just use to store our psych research project stuff. If we do that, we inherit a bunch of awesome tools such as PackageDown. Basically, once we put our materials inside the R package standard, we get neat stuff like the ability to automatically compile a website and share everything without having to learn how to code a website. So we're talking about communicating all of this stuff in the form of GitHub repositories, and this is useful because we can connect to OSF, have a nice website, have an R package. There's a lot of stuff going on here, basically. This is an overview of the structure of a vertical project. I'm going to go past this pretty quickly because I think this is kind of a lot to look at. And over the course of these vertical videos, we'll be going into detail about what all this looks like. The bottom line is we have a template for you. When you turn it on in RStudio, it creates this file folder structure for you. And you go in there, and for example, if you write your paper in the manuscript folder, you write your slides in the slides folder, you write supplemental materials in the vignettes folder, you put your data in the data folder, and we can even do things like write R functions and put them here, and a number of other useful things. When we do that, we can then make use of some awesome R tools like PackageTown that make free websites for us. So for example, this would be an example of a PackageTown website where if we had some content such as a paper, supplementary material, slides, posters, even experiments and R functions, this website will be created for you. You don't have to learn to program it, but you do have to just kind of put your content in the right places. And we think this could be a useful way to share your work, especially because research projects have so many different assets associated with them and beyond papers. Okay, so there's a bunch more we can say about this, but at the end of this brief overview, I wanted to mention a few simple things. Here's how you could install Vertical. You need the DevTools package installed, but just run this line and it will download it off of GitHub for you. And there's two ways to initialize a new vertical project. You could use this line and then this line to build the website. And I'll just, or you could use the RStudio new project ability. So let me just give you a quick example of what this kind of looks like at the very, as an example. So I've opened up RStudio. I have Vertical installed already. I'm going to click New Project. And if Vertical is installed properly, when you create a new directory, you can scroll down and there should be a new Vertical Research Project option here. So this is a template. You get to choose what parts of the Vertical project you want to insert into your project. So I'm just going to call this Test Vertical 1. And I'm going to save this on my desktop, and I'm going to initialize this as a Git repository and a few other things. I'll just leave these as the default. So we're going to get a manuscript, slides, poster, a few other things. So let's create that project and see what happens. All right, so here we are. We've created a new folder called Test Vertical 1, and we've got some things here that we'll go over in great detail in the remaining videos. Let's take a look at the manuscript folder. There's in here a manuscript.rmd. If you're not familiar with the PapaJaw package, this one allows you to write APA papers in R Markdown. So that's the template that comes with PapaJaw. You can write slides in R Markdown. So there's some slide templates that come in here. You can write posters in R Markdown. So there's a template here for that. These are different kinds of content you could create using R Markdown. can put supplementary materials here. And as we'll learn later, there's some folders such as R and the man folder isn't here, but this basic folder and file organization structure is an expansion of the files you need to write an R package. Okay, so let's say that you'd actually written a paper, poster, slides, supplementary materials, and you've stored them in these places. Here's what's kind of cool. And I'll just go back and copy this line. Vertical, build vertical. As we'll learn later, this is just basically a wrapper to package down function to build a website out of these things here. But let's check it out. We'll run that. And this is what we get. And so this is a website that can be expanded. The front page doesn't have anything on it yet, but let's say this was for a paper of that you wrote. What's happening here is there's a link to the manuscript, so there's the PDF you can look at. If you have supplementary materials as additional R markdown documents, you can have people look at them here. If you packaged with this R functions, you could even share that as a package. So in this case, the name of the R package would be test vertical one. And you could have you could load the functions associated with that package here. We can link to slides, and we can link to posters. And all of that stuff can be made in R Markdown, which allows the materials to be reproducible in the sense that somebody can download the source code document, the RMD document, and verify that it runs on their own computer to produce the same output that you did. I'll just give you a quick additional example. So I recently converted a cognitive science proceedings to a vertical repository, and it looks like this. So I added a few things on the front page. Here's the name of the paper, put a figure there. You could read the paper by downloading it from that link. I also listed here all the code that we needed to run all the simulations in this paper. So I have, this is a sort of slim version of a vertical project because I didn't do things like write an R package for this one. But this demonstrates, you know, how you can kind of mix and match and do what you want with a vertical approach. Okay, I think we're going to end that here. And yeah, I guess I should play some synthesizer on the way out.